Welcome to the 10-minute tutorial for research. My name is Alistair McLean. I am a Principal Solutions Architect here at AWS. And today we're going to talk about quantum on AWS cost estimation. The agenda for today will cover the four following topics. First of all, estimating the cost of quantum computers, estimating the cost of simulators, estimating the cost of hybrid jobs, and estimating the cost of notebook and storage costs. So to estimate the cost of quantum computers, we have to be familiar with the task and shot model that Amazon Bracket uses. For example, users will submit tasks. Tasks are comprised of many shots. Each quantum computer has a different cost for shots and a per task price of 30 cents. For example, if you wanted to submit a single task with 10,000 shots to the D-Wave Advantage quantum annealer, the example on the right of your screen takes you through the calculations involved. So we would want to submit a single task, and that task is going to be comprised of multiple shots, in this case, 10,000 shots. So we calculate it by the 30 cents upfront per task cost and the $0.00019 per task cost times 10,000, because we're going to call 10,000 shots. That gives us a total cost of $2.20. Please note that this cost model for quantum computers is solely based on the number of tasks and the number of shots each task contains. The next topic is the cost of simulators. Note that this is a very different cost model to the quantum computer cost model that we just covered. In this case, we're charged a per minute rate depending on which simulator we want to use. In users in this case submit tasks to the simulators, and depending on how long those tasks take to run determines the price of the final the total cost. For example, if we were to use our state vector simulator SV1 and the task took, say, in total 30 minutes a month to run, and we ran that for an entire year, actually we would not escape the free tier on this, in this case, and there would be a $0 total cost. The free tier for simulators is 1 hour per month for the first 12 months of Amazon Bracket usage. After that, you will be charged a per minute rate, which is billed to the nearest millisecond of usage, and the minimum is a 3 second usage time slot. You can see here in the table, the different simulators have different per minute rates, but they're all covered under that 60 minutes per month for the first year. The next topic that we're going to cater for is the cost of hybrid jobs. Hybrid jobs consist of using a classical compute component and a quantum component. What happens here is that you are charged both for the usage of the classical instance that runs part of your hybrid algorithm, the number of iterations that you wish to run that for, and then you get into the task and shot model familiar to you from the quantum computing section. The entire duration of the job is also taken into account, and the main charge there is going to be the classical EC2 instance. So for example, if we have a task that is going to run for 50 iterations, if a hybrid job that's going to run for 50 iterations comprised of two tasks, and each one of those tasks has 100 shots, you can see in the example on the right of your screen that our task charges are going to amount to $30. That's a fixed charge. The shot charges are going to be $3.50, okay, because we're running 100 shots per task, two tasks, 50 iterations. And then, of course, the classical compute in this instance is an MLP3 8x large, And that's going to cost $14.68 per hour to run. We're going to run it in this case for 26 minutes. So therefore the cost of the classical section is $6.36 for a total of $39.86. In order to run this hybrid job that takes 26 minutes to run, again, comprised of 50 iterations, two tasks, and 100 shots per task. And in this case, we're using the Rigetti Aspen 11 quantum computer. Finally, the other main component of Amazon Bracket is notebook and storage costs. Storage is primarily used, it primarily uses S3 to store the results from quantum computers. And the design of algorithms and basic data science is all conducted in a notebook. In this case, the notebook instance we're going to use is an MLC5X large. Result storage, we're going to give a conservative one gigabyte per month. And the notebook duration per month, let's say it's going to be 8 hours of using that notebook. So in this case, what we have is storage charges of 2.3 cents for the month, because that's the cost of a gigabyte in S3 standard, and a utilization of 8 hours of the MLC5X large notebook, which comes to a total of $1.63.2 for a total charge $1.66. That's how to estimate the cost of your notebook and storage usage. Obviously, if you use different types of notebook instance, that cost will alter accordingly. And if you use more often or more instances of that, that will also multiply up accordingly. Thank you so much for listening to Cost Estimation on Amazon Bracket today. Hope you enjoy the rest of the video series. My name is Alistair McLean.